tonight, the Barbara Grau Tenant Advocate Award is presented annually by LCBH in memory of Barbara Grau, a dedicated and passionate housing advocate of tenants' rights. The award is given to a person or entity making significant contributions to one or more of the following areas: working to remove discriminatory barriers preventing people from obtaining decent housing, assisting low-income renters in defending their rights in affordable housing, displaying exemplary leadership in the preservation of the identity and character of a neighborhood through affordable housing, or addressing the deterioration of affordable housing through community or citywide advocacy. This year's recipient of the Barbara Grau Tenant Advocate Award is Lizzie Rosenthal. Lizzie has been an attorney at LAF since 2006, where she's been a forceful advocate for housing justice. She currently serves as a supervisory attorney with LAF's Housing Practice Group. As Miriam Halbauer, the attorney from LAF, reminded Lizzie puts it, Lizzie has taken a leadership role in advocating for LAF's clients over large-scale issues, such as negotiating lease or administrative plan provisions that would affect the housing rights of larger groups of poor tenants. But she also is known to fight for individual clients whose cases never draw attention whenever justice requires someone to pull for them, and Lizzie pulls hard. Starting in 2013, Lizzie led a team of pro bono and LAF attorneys representing public housing tenants in a lawsuit against the Chicago Housing Authority to require CHA to fulfill its commitment to affirmatively furthering fair housing. The litigation centered on the Cabrini row houses, which are all that remain of the Cabrini Green housing projects demolished under the CHA's plan for transformation. Row house residents were promised that their homes would be renovated and preserved as public housing, and that they could return. The reality, however, was quite different. Most tenants displaced from Cabrini have been relocated to low opportunity neighborhoods, thus deepening entrenched poverty and racial segregation, while the former Cabrini Green sites in the surrounding neighborhood continue to add amenities and services. The litigation had some complicated twists and turns that I'm still trying to wrap my head around, including whether the control court actually controls the case. Suffice it to say, in September of this year, the parties entered into a settlement that will vastly increase the number of tenants who will be able to live affordably in the now high opportunity area, known as the Near North neighborhood, with access to quality schools, jobs, and public transportation, and the target that I understand is now there. I want to add that I understand from my colleagues at LAF that Lizzie is an exemplary supervisor for all of the staff attorneys and interns there, and I'd also like to say that the attorneys at LCBH have experienced Lizzie being very generous with her time and giving important insights on housing issues. So it's my honor to congratulate this panel for the Barbara Grau Award.
Thank you to the Lawyers Committee for Better Housing for this award. I did not know about Barbara Grau until learning that I was being honored in her name, and I spoke to Jack Kaplan to learn a little bit more about her. One of the things he told me that stood out is that Barbara wore her heart on her sleeve, and he told me how much she cared about her clients and their causes, and how that showed in her work and in her interactions with them, and that her clients always knew how much she cared about them. I can certainly relate to that passion. When we took on the row house litigation with the Cabrini Green Local Advisory Council, the tenant leader organization for the tenants at Cabrini, we had dim hopes of success. But how could we not stand up for what is right? How could we not use our tools as lawyers to give voice to the public housing residents? How could we not say loudly that the housing authority is selling out the poor for profit and making the city more segregated than it's been in a long time and more unaffordable than it's ever been? Doing what is right is not always easy, and getting kicked from pillar to post before getting CHA to the table was dispiriting. But we got something we almost never dreamed we could get, or we never dreamed we could get: more housing for low-income families on the Near North Side, more affordable housing near big box stores, supermarkets, public transportation, medical care, and schools. We also sent a strong message to the Chicago Housing Authority and the city that we are watching. But I cannot take credit for the work that went into this case. I had a team of some of the best attorneys at LAF, Larry Wood, Rich Wheelock, Danerica Brooks, and Lee Means, and some of the best attorneys at Sidley Austin, who brought their federal court litigation expertise to bear on our clients' behalf. Dick O'Malley, Mina Gersahati, Steve Horowitz, Rachel Goldberg, and William Bruce. And of course, we had the dedicated, motivated, active, and engaged residents and former residents of Cabrini Green, especially the members of the local advisory council, and particularly their president, Carol Steele, an activist who comes by her name honestly. She has a steel will and the political savvy of 10 Mayor Daleys, father and son. For all of them, I say thank you. They all remind me what I do